the KMNN studios, this is the Kids Morning News Network.
Good morning. It's Wednesday, April 17th, 2024, and there are just 258 days left this year, so make the most of each one. I'm Alex in the KMNN studio in New York. It is National Ellis Island Family History Day. Ellis Island is in New York Harbor. It was the first stop for millions of immigrants coming to this country between 1892 and 1952. A busy day on Ellis Island might see about 5,000 immigrants pass through, but on this day, April 17th, 1907, 11,747 immigrants passed through Ellis Island. That was more than any other day in its history. Breaking news, exercise is good for you. You probably knew that already, but there's a new study that says it's even better than we knew. It works like this. Imagine exercise as a superhero with three awesome powers. We already knew it helps your heart stay strong and your mood stay positive. But this new study shows these powers might team up for extra benefit. The scientists looked at info from over 50,000 60-year-olds. Turns out, people who exercised more had fewer stress signals in their brains. And a calmer brain can mean a healthier heart. So that suggests that exercise might actually help your heart by calming your brain down. So basically, getting active is a superpower for both your brain and your heart. Pretty cool, right? And the best part, exercise is free and totally doable for anyone. Speaking of being active, the torch for this year's Paris Olympics was lit in Greece yesterday, and now it will be carried by a relay of runners all the way to Paris, with a boat ride for part of the way. What in the world does that mean? Does anyone outside Minecraft still use torches? Well, yes. But to understand the Olympic torch, you have to know about the Olympics. Way back in ancient Greece, where the original Olympic Games started, they didn't have a torch relay, but fire was important. They lit special fires at temples to honor the Greek gods, especially Zeus, during the games. Fast forward to 1928 at the Amsterdam Summer Olympics. This is where the symbolic flame that we know today first appeared. It burned in a big bowl throughout the games, like a giant nightlight for the Olympics. 8 years later, in 1936 at the Berlin Olympics, things got even more interesting. Here's where the torch relay, that long journey of the flame, was born. Runners carried the flame from Greece all the way to Berlin. Ever since then, the torch relay has been a big part of the Olympics. It symbolizes the passing of the Olympic spirit from Greece, the birthplace of the games, to the host city. People from all walks of life, even everyday heroes, get to be torchbearers. Pretty cool, right? Normally, the flame is lit with, get this, a big mirror. Regular listeners may remember that we talked about Archimedes' heat ray a couple of months ago. That was this legendary invention from ancient Greece that used giant mirrors to set enemy ships on fire. So yes, the modern Olympic torch lighting uses a version of Archimedes' heat ray. Except this year it was cloudy. They had to light it with the fire. So the next time you see the Olympic torch, you'll know it's a tradition that links ancient Greece to the modern games. Riddle time. Monday's riddle was, I fly forever, I rest never. What am I? Answer, the wind. Today's riddle is, Until I am measured, I am not known. But you will miss me when I have flown. What am I? I'll say that again. Until I am measured, I am not known. But you will miss me when I have flown. What am I? We'll find out on Friday. Ever think about being an astronaut? NASA is looking for new astronauts. But applications were due yesterday, the 16th. And also you have to be 26 years old and have a master's degree and be a pilot. Okay, maybe that's not going to work out just yet, but here's the next best thing. April is Citizen Science Month at NASA. And on NASA's Citizen Science webpage, there are projects that people of all ages can help out with. They have real scientific studies for you to help with. Everything from looking out for distant galaxies to helping identify coral reefs here on Earth. It's like being a part of NASA while you're still a kid. Like an adventure book where the kid gets to help out with some big earth-changing quest. Who knows what you'll discover? You can check out the webpage at science.nasa.gov/citizen-science. Wow. Probably easier to check them out on Facebook at Do NASA Science, which is all one word. Do NASA Science. In the weather, it looks like it could be rainy today here in the mid-Atlantic states. You could see some snow in Montana and Wyoming with more rain in Nebraska. And the southern half of the country will be feeling some spring warmth. Enjoy. It's International Haiku Poetry Day. Haiku is a kind of poem from Japan with a very particular form. It has three lines, five syllables in the first line, seven syllables in the second line, and five again in the third line. They're often about nature, but I made one up for today, so here's one about Haiku Day. It is Haiku Day, when we celebrate poems written just like this. Yeah, not too bad. Can you come up with a haiku? Remember, five syllables, then seven, then five again. Make one up and send it to me. Get your grown-up to help and email kidsmorningnews@gmail.com. That's the show. Thank you very much for listening. If you like this episode, please subscribe and hit the like button on your podcast app. And of course, spread the word about the Kids Morning News Network. We're already up over 3,000 downloads, and that's all thanks to you spreading the word. Grown-ups, if you'd like to become a supporter, there's a link in the episode description. Thank you to everyone who has already made a commitment to be a supporter. I'll be back Friday. I hope you are too. From the KMNN Newsroom, this is Alex signing off.